And on the phone this morning, as promised, we have Catherine Gordon, who is a teacher at Bangor High School. Good morning, Catherine. Welcome to the Mighty Moose.
Thank you for calling.
Well, that's great.
Been quite a whirlwind for you, huh, Catherine?
It's been a little crazy. Fox National News carried the story. It's been on BuzzFeed, and you're actually the fourth radio station to call this morning.
Unbelievable. Well, it's great to have you here. So glad you took the time to talk with us here in Augusta.
Oh, thank you so much for calling. I appreciate it.
Sure.
Now, when you made the post Friday on your Facebook page about this Christmas tree that you're no longer allowed to have in your classroom, did you expect what has happened, what has transpired?
No, I just thought it was a message to a handful of my friends, and it literally has exploded. I had no idea. You know, I'm not a political activist. I didn't, you know, make that point to make any, political comment. I just was sad that I had to take, a pink Hello Kitty tree out of my classroom.
Yeah, well, now, unfortunately, everything in and around holidays and celebrations, it seems, that can even be considered the least bit non-secular or point toward a certain religion or something. Everything, people are so careful. What do you think of the principal telling you you can't have the tree? Why did he do that? I mean, what is
why
the
this
feeling?
Year?
Well, I know. I've decorated my classroom for the holiday for 30 years. I used to have a big, huge, tall green Christmas tree in my classroom. We used to have them in the main office. We used to be allowed to have, parties with cookies and music the day before vacation.
Of course. Always did that.
We tried to go away from that to be more inclusive, to make all of our students feel welcome and comfortable, which is, the goal of every school system. But I just think in the guise of being inclusive and tolerant, which is a wonderful, commendable thing, we have just become intolerant of everything. And it's just, that was the point of my whole post was, not against my administration at all. They are in a very difficult position, no matter what decision they made. You know, they would take grief for it. But just that, what has our society become, basically? And it just made me really sad to have to take it down.
Now, did you call it a Christmas tree?
Yeah, I've called it that for 30 years. I'm a 30-year teacher at Bangor High School, and I've had one just about every single year. And, we are an inclusive school department. We had a lesson plan yesterday in our lower grades, coloring menorahs and talking about that. So it's just a little bit confusing to me.
Yeah.
But I think that it's opened a very good dialogue among our community, among our school. And that's a good thing when we can talk about it and figure out what's the best way to make everybody comfortable in our school. That's a good thing that's come out of all this.
Do you think the fact that you called it a Christmas tree and because that, and I don't personally, I don't get it. I think personally that it's stupid that we can't have a Christmas tree in places, personally. But
it's just, I don't know. I didn't have one parent complaint in 30 years, not by email, not by phone. Not one child in 30 years has come up and said, I don't like that, take it down. So I had no one ever in 30 years ever complain until last Friday.
Who complained, if I might ask?
Well, I shouldn't have said complain.
That's when she was told to just take
Okay.
It was my principal.
Yeah.
It was my principal.
Right.
He's the only one in 30 years that has asked me to take it down. And, he was in a tough place. It was not directed negatively towards him. I just think whatever decision he made was probably going to get him a little bit of backlash, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
This has just mushroomed out of control. It's really been a hot button topic about the tolerance level and what's acceptable and what's not acceptable. And it was not meant in any way to be offensive. It was pink and I thought it was fun and the kids enjoyed it. And they were actually really sad when they came into my classroom yesterday. They didn't say, where's your tree? They said, where's our tree?
Right.
Oh, our tree.
That's
I know.
Sad. That is
really sad.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, one of the things I'm wondering, Catherine, now we've heard from the principal and the superintendent, have you actually been talk to?
No, since I was told to remove it from my classroom on Friday, I've had not one email or personal visit from any administrator.
I just hope there's not any backlash on you for talking out about this.
It made me a little nervous.
Yeah.
I don't think it's any coincidence that my friend Kirsten White came to visit me. She's a Washington, D.C. lawyer.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
We had some good conversations around that topic.
Well, that's good. That's what I've been a little worried about. It's like, come on.
I've had no comments.
Fantastic.
Positive or negative from them. But,
interesting.
I just think it's been a very difficult couple of days for everybody, and it has opened up a wonderful dialogue. And I truly meant no offense with a pink tree, and nobody has ever said anything to me in 30 years until Friday. So there was no policy change. We got the same generic message that we've gotten every year, and so since it's been up every year for years and years, I just had no idea that this year it was inappropriate, or I never would have put it up. So
interesting.
It's opened to the dialogue for sure.
So if you put it up again and call it a holiday tree.
I'm not a political activist. And I think the activity takes down and we sit down.
Just a curious question.
Yeah. No, but it's a good starting point for the conversation, and I think you've done a great job with that.
Because we have faculty members that wear, the Grinch's old Christmas ties, and lady faculty members with the holiday sweaters, and they haven't been asked to remove those items, and so it does lend to good conversation about what is appropriate in our schools, what's going to make our children comfortable, what's going to make our staff comfortable. That's a good thing. Even though I'm very sad about the whole situation, hopefully some good conversation will come from it.
Well, we have a poll at our website, 92moose.fm, and overwhelmingly it's like 98% agree that you should be allowed to keep the tree. So,
thank you, listeners. I appreciate that. And I've gotten so many amazing comments from past students saying how much they had appreciated seeing, a cheerfully decorated room. And so that part of it has been amazing. Kids from 20, 25 years ago sending me supportive messages. So that's been really wonderful. And this morning when I picked up my phone from last night to when I turned it on this morning, there were over 250 messages of support.
Unbelievable.
So, it kind of has cheered me up a little bit. All this positive energy is a good thing.
So let me ask you this, and this is just a little bit off topic. Do they not allow teachers to say Merry Christmas or have a nice Christmas holiday season or Christmas vacation?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm definitely not going to say it this year.
Okay,
I'll say it to all of you. Merry Christmas. I hope you have a wonderful holiday.
Merry Christmas to you too, Catherine. Thank you so much for joining us, and very best
of
luck.
Thank you so much.
Keep us up to date, and I know you're a busy lady, and
you have to go to school, right?
Yeah.
I am. I have to be to work in 15 minutes. Oh,
thank you very much, Catherine.
Thank you so much. Take care.
And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.